You're the one that's going to open the meeting. I think you would might want to note that our third assessor is not in attendance.
Open a meeting for the Whately Board of Assessors Tuesday, November 21st, 2023 at 5 o'clock. Two of our three assessors are here. Kathleen Grady, myself, Fred Orlowski, and our assistant assessor here, Cynthia Herbert. Okay. First item is motor vehicle abatement
There aren't
application.
any.
Okay. Next item, signed Chapter 61A and B applications.
There aren't any new ones, but we
okay.
do have a couple of things that do need to be signed. This one is just you,
okay.
And that's our big bill for the year. And then there was, I believe,
Chris, I have a question in my head, so I'm going to ask you now.
Yeah.
So you're saying the funds for that, the 250 or two, whatever, went to a management company, sort of, whatever.
Well,
it came out of that fund.
Yes.
And who in the town hall knows those numbers?
That person.
That person.
And even our treasurer did not know how
okay.
much they got.
Well, maybe
some
we
individual.
Should address who that person is and ask them what, you know.
Everybody's got a pun. Never mind.
Well, they knew about it last year, last year's meeting.
And they didn't say anything.
And I brought that comment up, you know, look at all the donations you're getting for a celebration. And
okay.
That person never said a word to say
okay.
How much or how many.
So
or
that
whatever.
Person doesn't want to share the information that
No.
would be important to us.
Yes.
Okay.
I think you could say that.
Now, the number, I knew which ones donated because they put out a list of the ones that
yeah.
donated.
Yeah.
But there's no information how much they donated. And I think there's like 22, at least 22 people
on that
list. There were
yeah.
commercial businesses, not private entities. There was
yeah.
another 20 of private individuals.
Yeah.
But at least 22
wow.
commercial businesses donated money.
Yeah.
So I don't know if you want to figure what, $100 a business, that's what, 20?
Do you know what the total amount was?
No.
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 You don't even know the total amount.
You can't get those numbers. Someone's holding them back.
Oh, I know.
Because
yes.
they were by that corporation that's
well,
set up to manage that.
Yeah.
The town gave them money, and I guess if the town, if they spent, well, they paid the bills for it. The town did not. So that's why the town never saw it.
Yeah, but the
so
town knows, had a play.
But,
we know
yeah.
what it is. Somebody
Right.
does. Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Very interesting.
Okay.
And then there are those. And then last week when we met, or 2 weeks ago, you signed two liens, but they were both forest liens. One has to actually be a 61A lien. So if you would like to sign that. This is,
oh, yes.
These are both on the Robert Schrader.
Just one on this one.
Just the one thing. Yeah, it's just you. And it's just the one bill, big bill, year long.
What's that?
That's what you just signed. I had to write it. It was got so confusing what exactly he was hoping to do. And it's not really cleared up because what is, you know, you and I
yeah,
saw
yeah.
where the trees are,
yeah,
the Christmas
yeah.
trees are definitely only in Hatfield.
Yeah.
So
okay.
It makes sense that the other be switched to 61. And my note says that he will contact the forester to change it. But
yeah,
I didn't hear anything today. So the thing I gave, and I think I sent it around, so you probably all copied it, but the memo I sent around concerning the issue of the split rate,
right,
you all got.
Yeah.
right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, I'm sure I did.
And I printed it out, but of course
Yeah.
now when I find it again, probably. So I did all the things that answered the questions. I answered all the questions that were specifically asked of us.
Yeah.
I didn't go down through the four questions. Obviously, we don't. Number two, the open space is not relevant since we use the open space designation for chapter.
Yeah.
I went through to show, let me get these out of the way because it's going to start getting
Yeah. Yeah.
all day I've spent just trying to straighten out papers and not confuse myself. So I went through, and the memo, if you remember, just referred to properties A, B, C, D, E.
Right.
These were the ones I pulled off of the list
Okay, yeah.
that were relevant.
For
So
commercial.
that was where that, why can't I find it? Oh, it's right here. This was the memo. This has, okay, these
Yeah.
are not the final ones. Yours have the name,
Names.
yours have the map and lot.
Yeah.
Somewhere
Yeah.
I
Yeah.
have copies of it
Yeah.
with all of that
Right.
obliterated,
Okay.
since it's not for public
Right.
disclosure.
Okay.
So that was out of, there were 34 listed and there were two duplicates in it, so it was out of 32.
Okay.
I'm not sure what all that means, but
Okay. Yeah. Well.
and I forwarded it. Did I forward all this to Brian?
You said, yeah, you gave him a copy. You said
Yeah.
after, well, you changed the original copy. You
I
gave
went
him.
in and I said I'd like to swap out that, and
Yeah.
he was fine with that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yes, he has it. I did not send it to the select board. All right. So you two will have to vote on the split. I don't know. You do you want to talk about what
Well,
you?
okay, yeah. Well, the other thing that I did not do, which we did last year, if you remember, they wanted some property owners' values and to see what effect the split would have
Right,
on it.
right.
I didn't go through that exercise
Yeah.
to do that. Randomly pick three or four residents and three or four commercial and see what the impact would be. I didn't do that. And the other thing I did not do is, and I think Brian's memo says to get on the DLS
Yeah.
network, you can look at options
You
for
can
a split,
set up different options, yeah.
but you have to log into that
Right.
system. Okay, I didn't log in. I just went like anybody can get on there and see information that's already available.
Yeah, I don't think you can do it without logging in.
Okay,
But
but
once you log in, it does runs the numbers for
yeah,
you.
we'll tell you
It'll
what
run your
split you want.
numbers. So you can do like a 15% difference in
Yeah,
the split,
huh?
20
Yeah, yeah.
from the lowest, obviously, up to what the you have to stop at.
Yeah, yeah.
So I did not do that because I guess I wasn't interested in seeing the split.
Yeah.
Because once you do that, I guess you have to decide what percent you want to split. You know, that because it gives you a range
Right.
of I don't know, 5 or 10 different scenarios and different numbers. So you got to pick which one you want. Last year we I didn't do that. I think Brian did it or somebody else we had on the committee did it. And highlighted one or two of them to show the impact
Yeah.
of a split rate on commercial and residential. Well,
I mean, the thing is that our CIP is relatively low.
yeah.
I mean, obviously a place like Monroe that has the nuclear spot, of
Yeah.
course they want to shift,
Right.
or to Florida that has all those wind turbines.
Or urban,
Roe has something to do it also, doesn't it?
That's actually what I meant, Roe.
Oh, okay.
Or even
Yeah.
Irving has a split, yeah, that way.
Oh, so they have much higher,
Yeah.
well,
Yeah.
not so much Montague and Hadley. But I mean, Hadley has Route 9,
Yeah.
which, and I don't know, Montague, of course, also has Turner's Falls
Right.
and
Well, some commercial factories and whatever. So I'm not even going to look at different splits. We're not interested in
Yeah.
it. I'll tell Brian that. I'll share him what I put together before the meeting. And if they want to do different splits, let them do
Yeah.
that.
I don't see what the why even I don't understand why we're even doing it. So to lower the taxes on the residents, right?
Residents, yeah.
Yeah.
But really, in all fairness, when you look at the tax rate, we're the
Yeah.
second lowest.
Yeah.
That
Yeah.
doesn't
It's,
that
yeah, we've.
count for anything? I mean,
Plus, there are all these different programs that so many of the people that are lower income fit into. I mean, they tend to be the older farm families, so there's, like a widow who doesn't have much in the way of resources who gets this ever-growing amount of money taken off through the senior exemption.
Do you know some, one of this the prescription thing that people pick up, for insurance? It's gone from $32 to 73, the AARP one. That's just for prescriptions,
Wow.
from 33 all the way.
Doubled.
Well, yeah, more than doubled. Isn't it's everything is getting so expensive. But like you said, we have programs in place that,
And knocking $75 off somebody's tax isn't gonna.
it's going to make a big difference.
Well, and
It's just nearly silly. I don't.
that's why I come up with the reasons here that I thought pro and con. I couldn't have any, think of any other way to pro other than reducing the tax savings for residents. I don't know what else advantage is there
And
Yeah.
I mean,
to do it. I mean,
the taxes aren't that bad.
no, not
Well,
compared, yeah, to other communities, yeah.
compared to other communities, so I don't know.
So if you see something on my list that doesn't make sense, or I don't think I should bring up, I'm going to go through this list at our classification hearing
Yeah.
on December 5th to remind at least the select board that that's reasons that we don't want to split. So if
You
you
know,
see something or feel something I shouldn't talk about. Got time to change that because they haven't seen it yet. And then the other thing with the tax incentives for residents,
yeah.
the couple, the three there, I don't know, is there actually a veterans benefit?
Is there a veterans
Yeah, is there
benefit?
benefit?
Well, they have to have a minimum 10% war or service related doctor
Oh,
verified
so it's a
injury.
disabled.
It's
Or is
a
that a
yeah.
handicap? That's a
It's
handicap
a yeah,
benefit.
it's a disabled I mean people I mean tinnitus, there are a whole bunch
Yeah.
who get 400 off their taxes just for
You're
that.
saying tonight? What about tonight?
Tinnitus.
Oh. But is veterans benefit and handicap, they aren't the same, aren't
No, they're
they?
not the same.
Oh, they're
Okay.
not.
Veterans is completely controlled by the Veterans Administration.
Okay.
Look,
Okay.
the people who sit up in the office
Yeah.
in
Yeah.
Greenfield, for example.
Yeah.
And it's a whole set of let I have a whole
Yeah.
pamphlet on
Okay.
what's what. And it is based on extent
Yep,
of
injury.
service related injury.
Okay, so that's a veteran's benefit. What range or
What do they
dollar?
range to
Yeah, what?
from? They range from $400 off your tax bill. And of course, all of these people also get money
Yeah.
from, through the VA.
Yeah,
They
yeah.
all get monthly stipends
Yeah, my brother
if
gets that
they
money.
qualify for that, they
Yeah,
also get.
right. They get that. They're pretty much
Yeah.
get that. So they get from 400 up to We have four or five people who get $1,000 off. And then, of course, there is the guy there on Mitch Circle or his widow, and she pays no tax at all.
Wow.
Paraplegic.
Oh, okay.
So,
Dead now,
how many
however.
is, you said it's four or five that gets 1,000?
I
That's
believe
about
so.
it. And that's the lower one, the 400
And
is.
the 400, we must have 20 or so. We have about 20.
Okay, and now in the handicapped one, that's a separate one.
Now, what do you mean by handicap?
It says handicap. Oh, handicap
Is there a
benefit.
handicap benefit?
Well, there's a blind one. So
You
you have
don't
to,
have to be a veteran if you're
no,
blind.
you don't
Okay.
have to be a veteran. There's a blind one. That's what AI gets. And the
Yeah.
woman who owns that place on Chestnut Plain, that was a B&B. Can't remember her name.
Okay.
And then there is the senior exemption where you have to be at least 70
Yes, we
with,
have bought that up here.
right.
41C property tax.
Right.
Yeah.
And that one, and then there's one that has got less stringent income guides, but we don't actually have any
Oh,
of
the
them right now.
CPA property tax surcharge, are you talking about?
No, I'm
Oh.
talking about the, I always think of it as the widow's one, and that takes off a grand, $175. It's not worth the effort. And we don't have any. But
Oh,
people, it used to be people who didn't qualify for the 41C could get 17. I think it's clause 17. And it's much less money. But now, ours, unlike Colerain, which has kept it at the original level of a single person can't have more than, I think, 20,000 in assets, not counting their house,
good
and an
God.
income of no more than something like $5,000. I mean, it's ridiculous.
That's really way
Whoa.
below
Yeah. Or
poverty
maybe
level.
it was 15, maybe it's
Yeah.
15,000. But anyway, now we ours is much, much higher.
Yeah.
And because every year we use the COLA, which is applied, I'm hoping that's the way I've done it, almost like compound interest, where you don't each year go back to the 500 and
Yeah.
add the new COLA. You keep adding the COLA to the, you
Yeah.
know, the pre-existing COLA. So we're up to almost $600 now.
That's with the 41C.
Yeah. So,
Okay. But then,
as I think we said last year at the hearing, it would be more to the benefit of people who need it to get the information out about
yes, all these programs
all these programs that are
that will,
available.
yeah. You're going to find a lot of, especially the seniors, they just don't know.
Yeah.
I think they just.
Although if they have their, I know our tax person always would, you know, just automatically do that. What is it called?
I don't know.
Oh, it's something that only a ta it's done on your taxes. It isn't through the town.
Can't, but they can't automatically say, oh, that person looks like
Well, that's a
pretty
state.
old.
You're
I'm gonna
talking about the state circuit breaker.
circuit breaker. Oh, the circuit breaker, that's the taxes that you do every year. Yeah, Right.
yeah.
We have no
Circuit
idea
breaker.
how many get that.
No, no idea at all.
But for the 41C, how many people are getting that exemption? Do you know?
I can tell you. Oh, just
I'm not. That's
You probably don't meet the threshold for the, or you're over the threshold for income. So income.
am I looking for? I am looking for.
41C.
I'm looking for documents.
And also the other
I'm
one was.
looking for abatements and
Okay.
exemptions. Then I'm looking for last year. Okay, I can tell you exactly. You have. We have one, two who get the blind exemption.
Okay. How much is that?
437.50.
Each?
Each one gets
Okay.
437.50 off.
Okay.
We have, wow, last year,
Yes.
only three.
With
I
the
am
41
surprised.
states.
Yeah, the 41
See,
states.
I think we're not, I don't think it's reaching people.
Only three.
And added 600 or almost
Just
600
all,
patients.
yeah, 596 last year and whatever the COLA this year would certainly bring it up over the 600. We
Okay.
have one, two, three who get 1,000 off.
For what?
This is the veterans now.
Oh,
veterans.
And then we have the one that gets the full thing. And then we have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15. 15 who get
The
the
400.
400. And for that, you have to be, as I say, a minimum of a 10% doctor certified, service related.
And the one that gets the full amount, what how much is that?
What are the
1,000.
taxes? So that's like $5,056 last year.
5,000.
Oh,
Okay.
the one that gets the full one.
Yeah,
Yeah, they just
doesn't
pay
pay
whatever the
anything. Yeah.
taxes are. Yeah.
Doesn't even pay the CPA.
Okay. And how about the CPA surcharge? Is there any that?
We only did that, I think it only we only tried it once, and it was either Jim LaSalle
Yeah.
or it was Walter Arubin.
Ruben.
It was one or the other, and I don't know whether we automatically on the three, we only have the three, automatically take off the CPA.
Because you do it for the three.
Yeah.
And that's what, $100 each or something?
Two of them are about 100, and one is about 50. So, I mean, and we stressed this last year that this was a more effective way to
Yeah.
help the
Yeah.
population. Yeah.
And so now the handicapped, there's only, okay, two blind and then three others.
Two blind and three elderly. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, you could say, I guess, 20. 20 veterans who get the
Yeah.
benefit. Yeah,
Do the
Lorraine Jem, I
assessors?
don't, is Lorraine Jem still alive?
Who?
Lorraine Jem?
Don't know. I don't know.
She did not file, or her family did not file for her last year. That was always one of the 41 seats. Look back to. Yeah, we had four the year. Yeah, she had files a year before.
Okay. And now chapter land is there's a benefit to that.
Course.
And what is the benefit there?
Depends on the, if it's chapter 61, it depends on the use of the land.
Yeah.
Our standard excess land value is 3,000, I believe, per acre still. I don't think he changed it.
All right.
And the chapter value, the highest is vegetables at around 1,300 per acre. So there's a two-thirds saving right there. And that's for the highest use. And it goes down as low as, oh, around $40 per acre.
And how many we have in that?
Oh, a
Let me
lot.
check.
That's on that LA4. You'll see it listed. I'm thinking there are 61 parcels, maybe something like that. It's on the LA4.
What's
LA4.
the proper return?
Yeah. Chapter land. We have nine parcels. In 61, that's the forestry. Don't quite know why it says since 17. A says, I don't get the difference. I don't know what this is.
Hey, Leander, it's 45.
Yeah, or is it 70? I think it's the 70. I think it's the
Oh.
other column.
Oh, okay.
And B, there are 11. I don't know. I forget what that is. Yeah, do these. Don't do that inside column. I think it's these. So another 87, 97, about 100. And then there's the mixed use. So, it's very hard to pull it out. It would all be here. Here's the total amount
How much?
in
What
our
is the total?
class two. And that's, value.
Yeah.
4,233,000. Now, this is a mixed use number here. So maybe they get added together. I'm not sure.
Centrally valued telephone. I gotta get that out of something.
I sort of see Edith Ann there doing it.
Any other incentives or payments for residents,
Let me think.
or even for businesses? Do businesses, what do businesses get? Commercials, once is there stuff?
We don't do it
No,
because we don't give that small business thing.
none of the other businesses get anything.
But I, what I discovered, I mean, now what was it? How did I come up with my numbers? There was a rationale. Oh, the big thing is that land which is listed as commercial with a business on it has a much higher land value than residential.
Right.
And out of the 32, only a total of six are not on, are only four of the ones that are eligible, only four have land in commercial. So they're not paying a higher rate anyway. They're already getting the benefit of a
Yeah.
small business. And that was true for both commercial and industrial.
Industrial.
So
So say that again. There's
of the 32, four are have land that is listed as commercial. And I would say they're all legitimately, big enough, even if they aren't worth $1 million with a 10 or more employees, they're big enough to carry that extra load.
Yeah.
And only two of the industrial ones have land listed as industrial, which is the same value as commercial. And it's somewhere, oh, here. All these properties carry the commercial land value 138.1 per for the first acre,
Yeah.
which is
Significantly higher than residential.
about
Yeah.
50% higher, 40% higher anyway than the residential. So I thought that answered the question.
Yeah.
Then there were the four questions that had to be answered, or five, four. Six, two was the open space discount, so that you can't do. Three, the residential exemption. And four, the small commercial exemption. So you would only do the residential exemption by doing a split rate, I believe. I don't think there's any other way to do it. And then if you did that, the small commercial could be specifically kept at the residential rate, I believe, is the way it works.
Right.
But as I say, there are so few of them, and the few that there are all, with the exception of the tea guys, which is an interesting story that I wish I knew more about. Anyway, that's gone under. And he's, I guess, run off. I don't know. They can't find him.
What he do with his house on
Didn't he
plants?
leave? Didn't they sell?
They sold the house. Sold the house.
Oh, yeah, very quickly. It's
Very
been
quickly.
sold for ages. I never saw, knew them when they were there. They
Is that
left.
where Shakes lives, or how do you pronounce it? Shakes?
You're talking cheeks, aren't
I
you?
know it's Brandt.
Brand cheeks, yeah.
Yeah,
Okay, that's a
that's who
brand.
bought the house.
Right. Oh, okay. Okay.
So I guess what you guys have to vote on in terms of question two, it's irrelevant. Three and four, you'd have to say, yes or no to granting either the small commercial exemption or the residential, which in effect is the split rate, I believe.
Right.
So I think that's where it's at.
Okay.
So are we voting or still talking?
I don't know.
Well, you have anything else you want to bring up before we vote?
No.
Okay. And we can, well, even though we don't know what the rate's going to be, I
Yes,
guess.
well,
You
that's it.
have to because
They
you
aren't
can't,
telling us, so what can we do?
and you can't have a rate till you have classification. So, this is all signed.
Okay. I don't want a tax split. I don't think it's necessary. I think that we're doing quite well the way it is. I don't see the point of it. If someone could tell me the point of it.
Yeah. Well, it's only to save residents.
Yeah, but and we can't say how much because we don't know because we're not given any. But the thing is that it's not going to amount to that much, and it's
Well,
just.
and given the fact that the CIP is so low here, you would have to make it a quite a big split to actually have it be needed. But I do think that that amount of higher. That higher one on the businesses would drive away business.
Well, you take a look at the ones that have a split rate here. Monroe is well 11 and 24. Florida is 8 and 20. 8 and 13. Irving Row is 5 and 10. It's not like 5 and 6. It's double, almost a double the rate.
It sounds like it's more than double.
Yeah, and some of these are more than double. So,
And that's because they have one big industry. It's not because they have, three dozen businesses, small and larger along Route 5 and 10, which is very different.
So, okay, so make a motion that we to support a single tax rate. Okay, I'll second that motion. Okay, we vote on it. Kathleen, yes. Okay, me. Fred, yes. Okay. Open discount. Second question, doesn't apply because it's already included in
Yeah, didn't we already
the
say that?
residential.
Yeah, but it has to be done
Okay.
formally so
Oh,
that we
okay.
can.
Okay. Make a motion
Okay, yes.
that the open space discount doesn't apply. I second that. Okay. I'm in favor of that. Okay. Residential exemption.
Hi.
Right.
Hi, I'm
Hi.
Denny.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
We get the information that we sent out on the tax rate hearing
Yeah.
and the questions. Okay, we're halfway through voting on the questions.
Okay.
We discussed them here
Yeah.
amongst ourselves, and okay, just to tell you what we've done so far. Question one, we voted to support a single tax rate. Question two is for the open space discount. We've voted that that doesn't apply because it's included in the residential rate. The third one we're talking about now is the residential exemption, which would apply at a different tax rate for residents to shift the tax rate from residents to commercial.
I don't understand. That's great.
Well, it says, okay, they grant a res exception to all Class 1 residential properties that are principal residence of a taxpayer. Exemption may not exceed 35% average assessed value of Class 1 residential properties. When values produced by chosen, the overall tax level remains the same. That's the effect of shifting the tax burden within the residential class to owners of rental properties. Okay.
We have
Vacation owners
never,
and higher
yeah.
value homes. Okay.
We have never,
You don't have
we
that
have
split.
never had, if there are second homes, if there are people who only come here or use them as Airbnbs, I am completely unaware of them.
Yeah.
So to me, I
Okay, so
mean,
we're not doing a residential, we're not
no.
supporting a residential exemption.
No.
Because we don't have the kind of properties, and the people have never been asked about it. Okay, I make a motion that we don't allow residential exemptions.
I agree, yes.
Second, okay. Take a vote, okay, on not allowing residential exemptions. Kathleen.
No.
Okay, Fred, no. Marion.
Jenny,
Jenny, I
Jenny.
mean Jenny. You wish to vote?
Abstain.
Abstain? Okay. Okay. Question four was small commercial exemption. And we did receive the list from POR about the properties that were on this list that are have 10 or less employees and assessed value of less than 1 billion. There's what, five properties in town that are on that list of all the ones that they sent us. And that would mean that them five properties would get a rate the same as residential rather than commercial. Right?
I think that's the interpretation.
Interpretation.
It basically, I mean, there are 32 that the state picks out as being small businesses valued under a million. Although one of the ones I found was over a million with fewer than 10 employees.
Right.
Of those, only five of those 32 were on commercial land value anyway.
Oh,
So
okay.
they're already being, their land is already in at the residential
That's right.
rather than the
Yeah.
commercial.
Oh, okay.
So it sort of automatically shifted to the bigger ones because the bigger ones are paying commercial land value, which is about 50% higher than the residential.
Right.
So
Okay.
does that mean that the question one only applies to the
structures and not the land, that the land already has a split rate?
No. No. The tax rate is the rate per thousand, and it applies equally to land, buildings, and personal property. So whatever it is right now, it's $14.20. What the issue about having either a single or a split rate is really about is that the state will allow a town to shift some of the burden of taxation onto businesses, and it's a control thing. You can't just shift it all, but you can do like a 15% shift, and Fred has shown with what he's come up with, what the different tax rate is then for the town's people as opposed to the town's businesses. Whether a town has a large business base, the percent of the town that is in fact commercial, industrial, or personal property has a lot to do with it. If it's a town like Roe, which essentially has one business, and they have shifted, they do go for the split rate because they have pushed a huge amount of the tax onto Yankee Roll, even though it's non-functional. But they still have water. They still do their damming and all. And that lowers the tax rate. And that's been true all along as I've been doing this kind of thing. The people in Roe have had tax rates of around $4 per thousand.
Yeah.
But as a result, Yankee Row has had to pay, I don't know, like 20% or,
yeah.
I mean, $20 per thousand. So this really works in towns that have large, what they call CIPs, which is a commercial, industrial, personal, industrial, and commercial. This town has a relatively low one of about 20%. So to have any really effective impact on the tax burden on the residences, you would have to do a fairly big split.
Like, 40.
A big,
probably
as much as the state would allow. And I don't offhand know what that number is.
I think it's 50%.
50?
Shift, you could go up to 50%.
So choosing not to do that, though, I don't understand what question four is examining.
It's just properties that meet the two criteria.
The town is sent each year a list of these small businesses which you can give preferential treatment to. In other words, you can keep their tax rate. I don't know if it's the same as the residential or not, but you don't impose on them the much higher rate.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a list which only the assessors can see. It comes each year. And what my point was when I wrote the memorandum was that of those, really only 32, because there were two duplicates listed, only five altogether had land that was already being valued at a commercial rate. The others are getting their land valued as a residence, which already then is a break because it's considerably less.
Okay.
So, I mean, this used to all be done. It was pro forma,
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what the impact is on the collector in terms of how the computer has to be set to do a split rate, but obviously it's all in the computer. Nobody has to do any of this stuff out of, the pen and pencil. Most small towns, unless they have some particularly large, lucrative business like Yankee Row have just always gone with single rates. On top of that, before you got here, we were talking about the fact that there are many programs that actually benefit the residences who need it, as opposed to somebody who has plenty of money, probably doesn't need to have $75 taken off their tax or $100. They're going to be in houses that are valued less, so the impact is less. And there are various exemptions for age, which are income and asset linked. There are veterans benefits for veterans with service related injuries that get a certain amount of, off their taxes every year.
Handicap.
And then there's the blind.
Yeah.
Those are the ones we generally grant. We don't have much of a call for. I mean, there is that clause 18, low income, but
Yeah,
the
and
one
we don't do the widow's clause
we
up
just
here.
don't have anybody right now
Yeah.
that has applied that wouldn't get the 41,
Yeah.
and could therefore be dropped to the other. And
Yeah.
that's such a drop in the bucket anyway,
Yeah. Yeah.
$175 off of.
Yeah, but the other one, that 41C,
That one,
that's $600.
yeah, that's a significant
Just like
chunk.
that, the veterans benefit is up to 1,000. So
Yeah.
they're getting
So
breaks
there
there.
are,
The 41C, the age related
that's
one.
the age one, yeah, the senior exemption. And what we suggested last year when this whole issue became such a big issue was that they would be far better off. And actually, if what they're worried about are people on limited budgets, they would be much better off promoting the use of these various exemption clauses rather than granting, Peter Laird a lower tax
Tax
on
rate.
his house.
Yeah.
It's a lot more equitable.
Yeah. And I think goodwill comes into play as far as the few businesses that we do have.
Oh, and that's the other issue that
That
was also
really
brought up
donate
before
and
you
help
got
us
here.
out a lot. And
Yeah.
okay, so we've voted on the, well, three questions. Okay, the fourth one is the small commercial exemption. Okay, I'll make a motion that we don't allow that.
Yes, I yay.
Second the motion. Okay. So, okay, voting. Okay, I'll say no. No small exemption. Commercial exemption, you vote.
I yes.
Yes.
I'll abstain.
Abstain. Okay. Okay, that one passes. Okay. So all three questions pretty much have passed on two of the three of us voting. And so since you'll prepare something, a document,
The
say we
vote,
voted
yes, absolutely.
on that,
We'll do that tomorrow.
and I will come sign it, I guess, as the chair, whatever, and say we all voted.
Do I need to sign it too? Or just him?
It doesn't matter. No, I don't think you need to.
Okay.
List all the three of us that were here, the three
Right.
that voted, whatever. So, okay. Okay, so the next step is for us to present this information to the select board on December 5th, which will be a public hearing for the select board and for anybody in town to come. Especially businesses have come in the past, subject to higher tax rate for them. So, I guess I will be there. Then it's a hybrid meeting, so you can come here or do it on a computer if you want. I mean, it's set up for 7 o'clock. Yes, I'll be here. Will you
No, I will not be there.
available in for come here or remote?
I can come.
Come, okay. And you'll be here
No, I'll
till
be
then.
here.
Okay. So we'll plan on that. Okay.
We likely to have a meeting between now and then? No.
No.
No,
No.
probably not.
Yeah, it's a very,
It's very close,
yeah.
actually.
The only
In
other thing
fact,
would
I
be,
think it's 2 weeks, yeah.
the only other time would be that same day, early in the day, at like
I
at
don't
five,
think so. I don't
six,
think we need
that
it
would be.
unless, I mean, I can't believe there, if there were, then I guess you'd have to, well, I don't know how you could do it because you can't post that late.
Well, you'd have to post next week. Well, after you could post early next week, I guess. If you wanted for to meet on the 5th, it's
Yeah,
like six
I'm not
o'clock,
going to
but
need to.
we don't
Well,
need
I'm
to.
not coming home,
Okay.
so.
Okay. What else do we have on our
Think that's pretty
agenda?
much it.
Well,
It's time to go home to Shiloh.
we do a little business. Okay. We're meeting.
So what's on that screen is what they see.
I think
Isn't that
so.
something?
That's
They
great.
can't
That's
see
a,
anything.
oh, there you are. Oh, I thought I would mention that there were two sales today, and boy, let me tell you, sales have dwindled to almost nothing. But there were
Yeah.
two interesting sales today. Stanley Hoinoski's house,
Oh, yeah.
which we have assessed at 282.3.
282, you said?
282.3.
Oh, God, don't
Yeah.
tell me what it went for.
459.9. 460.
We were in there, well, I remember a couple of years ago.
Yeah, I think, well, we couldn't get in this year because no one was home. Remember, right after he died.
Yeah. I
Yeah.
remember before going in.
Oh, I can tell because I have the.
It wasn't any different than 50 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah.
Amazing.
And the people who bought it are living in it, so it's not like they're coming into it and saying, oh,
Oh, yeah.
surprise.
It's the old game, 459.
459.9.
Yeah, something.
Somewhere I printed out the sheets.
When is, don't we have an 8% increase?
And that included, I mean, that includes the 8% increase. Yes,
Oh.
we have a sort of across the board increase in both land and buildings this year of about
Assessment, yeah.
8%. An 8% total, not added together. And then the other one was the piece of the Posesnik land, not where the Simmers Creamy is, but
Yeah.
the other one,
Or the houses,
where the old house
the old
is.
houses.
Total of seven, almost 75 acres,
Yeah.
which we have assessed for a little under, and this is the chapter value, of about 790, and it just sold for 1.4 million.
Because there's more than a house. There was a bar,
There
a
is
couple of
a
constructions
warehouse.
around.
There's that big warehouse.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, right behind it was.
And then there's the
Right.
house, which is modest, but they don't care about the house. I mean, this is
Yeah.
all about the fact
Okay.
that it's good
Right.
farmland. The farmland is across the state is way
Yeah.
undervalued.
Does your reaction indicate that market values used to be closer to assessed values in lately?
Well, what you have to be, by state regulation, values have to be basically within 10% of your assessed values overall.
Say what has to do within 10%?
The assessed versus the market value. So you can't, like New York State, for example, there are towns where, well, I mean, when I lived in New York, you could have your brownstone assessed for $3,600, but it was worth 2 million. That was the way you, I mean, yeah, that's how some states do
Yeah,
it,
yeah.
and they will. But in Massachusetts, by law, you cannot get your tax rate certified by the state until your overall, the whole town, looking at everything, styles, area that the sales occurred in. It's all done on sales analysis, and you have to be within 10% of the market value. So if a house sells for 300,000, you have to be The house has to be valued, somewhere from the high twos into the
270 to
sort of
330.
mid
So
30s.
we're not right on it as far as.
Well,
And
you can't be. It's
but
an
I mean,
art.
my
It's not.
Mike, I have a lot of experience with Northampton, and they've never been close.
No. Well, they have to for their for how it shows up in their reports. Now, I don't know how they
So the
do it.
cumulative is what has to be
I
close.
think it's it's the sales. It's all done with these. You have to find your valid sales. You have to have so many per year. And then
I mean,
you
that's why ours is going up 8% across the board because of
of
sales.
sales.
Because of
Have increased
sales
the
compared to
values.
what we've assessed.
Yeah.
See, I didn't know anything about the 10%. I just always thought market values are higher
Yeah.
than assessed values in
Can't.
desirable towns.
Right.
Some towns that may not
Right.
be true,
Well,
but okay.
I mean, suppose I've never believed that it's, first of all, even within one town to be really, to stay within that. And they don't look at the whole, they look at the sales.
Yeah, they look at the sales,
It's
what
a
we assessed it
sales.
and when it sold out.
And you
Right.
throw out most sales because they involve government, they involve chapter land, they somehow
That formula
involve.
is going to perpetuate the problem, though, of people being priced out of their hometowns.
Yeah,
Yeah.
but almost any system will. But certainly, if you base it on just spot, number 20 sells for 200,000 more than all of its surroundings, somewhat similar. There are states that will just raise that one value. Here you can't do that. Here you look at, okay, it was a ranch house. I mean, we have ranch houses from the 70s, not particularly distinguished houses. That sell routinely and have for, I would say, the last 10 years, over 400,000 in Whately. Now, where I live, that same house would probably be 190.
She lives in the slums.
I do.
She
I live in Coleraine, out in the back of beyond.
can't afford to live here. Yeah.
I couldn't afford.
For
Yeah.
now, I mean, for
But it
now,
is a
Coleraine
problem.
doesn't pose that, but
Right.
okay.
Unfortunately, it hasn't had the kind of a building
Yeah,
boom
we've had a growth.
because,
Our growth has been,
yeah,
and then that neighborhood
because
down
you're
there
on
has
the
done
ninth
a lot.
corridor and just that much closer to the colleges.
I
It
don't think
has
we've had any sales less than 400 lately, have we? Haven't been anything
not, it's possible.
less than
That's
400.
possible
Yeah.
not, yeah.
Now, who bought the one? Was that Schmorowski's again? Or?
No, this is Jay Zinski, maybe.
Is
And
that?
there's a new farm stand now
Oh,
on that
is it in
property.
the
Yeah.
farm stand? Oh,
Yeah.
farm stand. Okay.
So that's the sale,
So
1.4
you
million.
know the one that just built the little shed.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a little
I know
share.
what
Yeah.
you mean, yeah.
That's okay. But well, where are they? They live at River Road. That's their address.
Yeah, that is
Seven
their
River.
address. Yeah.
Okay, I thought they were from Hatfield.
Well, they could very well be, and it may be that that's just their business address, would be my guess. They may be using the house as an office,
Well, it could be related to other
or it could be related.
businesses along that
Yeah.
in that area. I
Yeah, I mean, Swarovski spent a
yeah,
lot of money
yeah.
for Simmer
So yeah,
Screening.
right.
Yeah.
A lot of money for
Right.
another big chunk.
Yeah.
So,
And were we
yeah,
off
that,
on
yeah.
that
What?
one?
Yeah. But see, to answer Danny's question, that doesn't mean that now we're gonna assess that property
No,
for
you can't do
1.4.
that.
Yeah,
Right.
no.
Yeah. But the next time that we look at sales next year, and sales always reflect what happened generally a full year and sometimes even a year and a half
Yeah.
previous. So you're never doing it at the exact moment. And very often sales will fall into a span of time that never really becomes part of the sales testing that we do, the analysis. This house, the smaller house down the hill at Stones, not the one that's to the left of the
Yeah,
driveway,
okay.
that's on the market right now. We have not been in it since 29. We were given information, which means we probably were not allowed in. In 2015, it was built in 58, and we have an effective year built on it of 1990. We have it as a C grade in C grade in average condition.
What did we
And
have?
we have it assessed for 241.1,
It's on the market for.
and it's on the market now for 400. Just went on last week.
So that assessed value, that's the current rate with the 8% increase
Well,
or not?
I would have thought so, but I'm looking at, yeah, it is.
It is, okay.
Yeah, it was 224.5 last year. Now it's 241.
Yeah. You see, the other thing, Jenny, you're asked about land and value. Commercial land is assessed at a higher value than residential land. We've always done it that way. Residential land goes anywhere from what, 95 to
About 99, I think, yeah,
99?
99, and then depending, because
Thousand.
there are neighborhoods with long views and what have you that
But
go
then we
higher
start with the basic prices like 99,000 for a residential
for the first acre.
first acre. That's how we assess. Now commercial goes almost what, double that, right?
One almost 140.
To 140 for commercial land. So businesses are already paying
But
more
they do already
on
pay
the
more just because they're a business.
in the commercial
And if it's a
value of the
big
land.
business like Yankee, which occupies a large footprint of the land, it's not just a 1 acre that gets the higher rate. It'll be maybe 100,000 square feet that'll get the higher rate, or 200,000 square feet. So, and then the excess land, rather than being the 3,000, which is the residential for excess, is more like, I think, 25,000. So they
25,000. Oh, okay.
So excess land goes for a
Yeah.
lot more.
You got
I
quite a
mean,
bit.
a commercial land.
Commercial land, yeah. Yeah, because a good example of that was, you're familiar with DeMaio property on State Road?
I might be familiar with it, but not by the owner's
Well,
name.
no, but that one over there where
Where the
Swamp Road
restaurant
comes in,
used to be,
the
the
restaurant.
Swamp Road comes out onto
Yes,
5 and 10. The
the assessed
Lamp
value
Ladder or whatever that was.
just for the land was like it's in at 95 or 98,000 when it was residential. It was on residential. Planning board decided let's make it commercial so we can get hopefully businesses looking at it. It says value doubled to 198 or something for that parcel of land. No building, nothing, just the land. So I don't know if that's a hindrance to people that are looking about to build there. Because the sale price is going to be probably close to that. Realtors look at what it's assessed for as probably as a bottom line maybe and go up from there. So I mean just by assessing property commercial increases the value and maybe there's negative impact on businesses, new businesses coming in town. So
But if somebody wanted to buy and build a house on it, they could appeal,
yeah, you
right?
could. Yeah, you could still
Yeah, you could.
build a house. Yeah.
Yeah,
Yeah.
I think you'd have to think you'd have to
Go to the
take it
building,
to,
lo a planning board or
I
something,
would think so,
because you'd
because
have to change the zoning again, right? You'd have to go through the zoning.
yeah, because that was a spot zoning thing.
Yeah,
That's not part of the commercial district.
I'm really sorry for being late. I was all set to be here for 5 when my kid's pickup was at 3, and she called me at 2:57 and said, "No, I'm doing the play till 5 today." And I didn't realize till later that the impact that had. So you have an email that I sent, 70 minutes ago, but
Oh, I didn't
I
get it,
didn't
but now
store your
I will.
number, so I was like, all I can do is show up
Yeah.
and
Well, that's good. I'm
apologize.
glad you did.
That's pretty.
So I have to go.
Okay.
Say hi to Shiloh
Yeah,
for me.
because I don't know what he's done.
She has a puppy. Yeah.
He's a puppy, got a new puppy.
Wait, I'll show your coat.
Yes, don't go without your coat.
Yeah. Well, she won't go very far before she remembers.
Where'd you get them from?
Oh, down the street. I got them from Stafford, Connecticut.
Oh, he's what is it?
His name is Shiloh.
Shizitsu, whatever is that?
Is
Is that the,
what do you
what do you call that kind of dog? Shih Tzu.
That's not a Shih Tzu.
Isn't that what you call that?
There, that is a dog
That
name,
is
and
a
it's got
dog,
these
yeah.
little long hair
That looks
on
like
it.
a
Oh,
Shih
yeah.
Tzu.
I don't know. I'm
It's
not
very.
into dogs, but I hear
What
people
is a
have
Shih
them.
Tzu? They're little
Small,
dogs.
little, long-haired
Dog, yeah.
dogs.
Well,
They kind of look
this
like
is
a mop.
not a Shih Tzu. What is it? I forget. You told me.
It's a blend of Emal, Irish
Oh,
Terrier,
Irish
and
Terrier.
some random Aussie who broke into the breeding.
AK State Registered, all right.
The breeding one,
No,
the mother
not
was.
this one. This one's a mutt. Until
Well,
they decide to call it a
works
whatever,
better for you, right?
yeah,
Yeah,
they'll come
whatever
up
they
with a
do.
thing and then
Well, no, the thing of it is this dog is not going to be. See how long the legs are? Almost as long as the body.
yeah.
So it might grow into its legs.
So how old is he there?
He's let's see, he's 4 months now.
4 months.
Yeah,
Okay.
he may have been 3 months.
So he'd be
Let me
what,
see his
twice that
picture
size?
again. He
Full grown?
was, he visited here
He came.
last
Oh, he
year.
came? Oh.
Here's his new coat.
Oh God, he is cute.
There's his
He
new
is
coat.
really cute. I have to say, just makes me
Nice.
miss my dog.
Yes.
Oh,
You
okay.
see, he's not that. I don't think you're thinking one of those little
Yeah,
pre.
the little ones, yeah.
Those
See?
little mops.
Well,
Do you
yeah.
see how he looks different colors? Oh yeah, no, he's beautiful.
That's brindle.
Yeah, you got
Okay.
it. I didn't know what it
So
was
go.
called.
Okay.
And here's his enthusiasm.
Oh God. Oh,
This is what I'm
hope he
going home
starts
to.
doing that right now.
He's all loose in the house.
Yes, I ran out the
Well,
door
there we go.
I ran out the door to get here, and then as I'm coming up, I realized that I didn't put him into it. I have a little room that I put him into. Do not crate my dog. I don't like crates.
Yeah.
I have a crate, and he goes there to hide away from the cat,
Oh.
who they about weigh the same amount.
Same.
So,
You got a good sized cat, huh?
Well,
Okay.
10 pounds. The
Oh, that's
dog
not
was
big.
only 7.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
All right. Well, have a good Thanksgiving.
Oh,
Yes,
you
let's
too. I
do it.
forgot that's coming.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Have a good one.
Should we close ourselves out of this?
Okay.
You want to
Any
adjourn the
other
meeting?
business? No.
I didn't put in anything about an executive meeting because I didn't
No,
think we were going to
okay.
have one.
Motion.
Now, of course, I've got to figure out how to do this again.
Okay, during the meeting.
And there we go.
Okay.
Only I could see. Stop recording.
Yeah.